As Washington remains on edge, tens of thousands of National Guard troops are on their way in an effort to secure the nation's capital. CNN's Shimon Prokopez is live for us there in Washington. And Shimon, no one can go to the National Mall on Inauguration Day. Explain that for us and just what sort of security preparations are in place.
Well, the security here is just extraordinary, Brooke. It's intense. You can see behind me, here is where the Vice President, the President-elect Joe Biden and Vice President-elect Kamala Harris behind me here, this is where they're going to take the oath. Of course, this famous stage on Inauguration Day. And what you see, all of this area surrounded, it's surrounded by troops, National Guards personnel out here in force, really. Does not look like the United States. This does not look like Washington, D.C. It really looks like they're almost protecting an embassy in a foreign country. It's really remarkable. They're heavily armed, and they're just surrounding this entire area for blocks, and we keep seeing more and more troops coming in, and they're stretched all the way down the street here, all the way down. There's more personnel down this side, and there are military vehicles. Also, I want to show you something else. As an added layer of security, there's going to be new fencing put up here. This fencing here seems like they're going to be putting up. There are these metal barricades here that they're going to be putting them up along the roads here. So this just added layers and layers of security. There are people still out here. I assume in the coming days, people won't be allowed here. Behind us here, Brooke, I just want to show you briefly. This is where they're building out a lot of the inauguration stage, the areas where people are going to be, I guess, performances and such for the inauguration. That's still very much ongoing. You could see they're building that out. But it's really remarkable to see the scene out here right now. It just does not feel like something you would see in this country, the military personnel surrounding the Capitol now, Brooke.
No, it's so striking. You know, Shimon, we've all been out covering inaugurations for many, many presidents past, and just the difference. You know, here we are. This is America. Shimon, thank you. On the Mall there in front of the Capitol. Now, these security preps come as federal investigators have issued a sober warning. Extremists, just like those behind last week's insurrection at the U.S. Capitol, are now likely more emboldened to carry out further attacks. CNN's Jessica Schneider is in Washington. And Jessica, why? Why do these investigators think these people feel more emboldened?
Yeah, Brooke, this is all based on what investigators are seeing as they're scouring social media and taking in tips. They're seeing this chatter that indicates these extremists believe that they were successful when they stormed and attacked the Capitol last week, and now they're emboldened to take further action. So this is how a law enforcement bulletin that we've obtained reads in part. It says, with the perception among some extremists that the breach of the U.S. Capitol building was a significant advance towards achieving their ideological goals, they may be inspired to carry out more violence. And the bulletin overall, it projects that possible targets here could not only be government officials, government buildings, but maybe even racial and religious minorities. And Brooke, this bulletin says that conspiracy theories are driving this possible extremist violence, the same conspiracy theories that we're often hearing from the president. So law enforcement, they are working to tackle these threats from every angle. Local agencies are sending help here to Washington. We know that FBI Director Chris Wray held a call yesterday alerting officials across the country about the threats in all 50 state capitals. So this is far and wide, and law enforcement is just trying to wrap its head around all the threats that are out there. Brooke.
And wrapping their heads around all the arrests that are now coming in from last week. I know authorities arrested this one of the guys seen on a video hitting a Capitol Hill police officer with a fire extinguisher. Who is he?
Right. We're seeing multiple people charged every day. So, Brooke, the latest you just mentioned is a retired Chester, Pennsylvania firefighter. He is accused of striking
a firefighter.
A firefighter. Accused of striking multiple officers with a fire extinguisher. You can see the video here. In this criminal complaint, it identifies the man in the video outside the Capitol as Robert Sanford. He's in that video wearing a dark plaid shirt and backpack, and then he appears to pick up what appears to be a fire extinguisher, throws it at that group of officers. It hits one officer in the back of their helmet, then ricochets and hits another officer without a helmet before striking a third officer. You can see that video right there. So that's one set of charges against someone who, you know, swore to uphold the laws of this country. And more charges just announced against a father and son in Delaware who entered the Capitol. The father, Kevin Seefried, he was pictured inside the Capitol holding that Confederate flag in Brooke. We know that now he and his son have been arrested. In fact, the person in that picture right there, he admitted to the FBI that he brought his Confederate flag from his Delaware home where he usually displays it. So these arrests are coming quickly, and there are a lot of them, and there are a lot to come, Brooke. A lot happening with law enforcement.
Un-American. Jess, thank you. Jessica Schneider in Washington. Joining me now to discuss all of this, Anthony Ferrante. He's a CNN law enforcement analyst and a former FBI special agent. So, Anthony, thank you so much for jumping on with me. And I just want to begin with the notion that some of these folks are feeling more emboldened because of how, you know, quote unquote, successful they were last week in the insurrection at the Capitol. And then officials are worried now they're going to come back and really be ready. What do you make of a chilling warning like that?
Yeah, it's certainly concerning, Brooke. I mean, I just want to say that Shimon was just reporting on the west side of the Capitol. I'm on the east side of the Capitol in a traditional residential neighborhood here in the United States of America. And outside my front door, I have 12 members of the National Guard standing a post with automatic weapons.
I mean, did you ever in a million years think you would ever be seeing that?
Yeah, it's unbelievable to me. I mean, I've traveled all over the globe, and this security around the U.S. Capitol right now. And that's one thing I really want to drive the point home to your viewers is this isn't security around the Capitol itself. This is security around Washington, D.C. It is 100% in residential neighborhoods and affecting our way of life. That noise you may be hearing are the barricades that they're putting up on my street right now. So it's very surreal. And the fact that what happened last week is now emboldening these actors is extremely concerning. I can tell you for certainty that the FBI is 100% all hands on deck. Why do I know that? Is because throughout the last few days, contacts around the country have called me with concerning information, and I have connected them with FBI agents at their local field office. And when I speak with the FBI agents, they say it's unbelievable. We are working 24/7, running down thousands of leads.
Good on you for connecting them, because, you know, we're talking security, yes, not just around Washington, but, you know, across the country. And just to remind our viewers, you know, some of these U.S. capitals allow open carry, right? So the danger is exponentially greater when you know, as a law enforcement officer, right, trying to keep people safe, you know that people could be there and armed. How does law enforcement prepare for that?
Yeah, it's super difficult. And that's why we all need to come together. I mean, listen, we've all lived the last few years. We've all seen what's transpired live in the United States. Okay, this is an attack on our democracy. We need to come together as communities, look down the street, left, right, look at your neighbors, report anything that's concerning. Please don't sit home and only rely on the FBI. Everybody plays an active role, and we can all come together and help. And that is what is super important we need to do right now. Inauguration of the President of the United States is supposed to be a celebration. And right now, the United States is hunkering down for war. If you walk outside my door right now, you would think you were in a green zone of a country laced with war right now. That's not who we are in the United States. And I just want everybody across the country to know that we're better than this, and we need to come together and unite.